Alright, it's a rainy afternoon on the eastern side of Jamaica, and I am on my way to town to pick up my sister. Jamaicans comply? No, they don't. They just speed away. Like, wet roads are nothing. But that's how it is. So I'm gonna try to keep within a reasonable speed limit. I'm telling you, this global pandemic has shut down the whole place. No, New York is under quarantine, California is under quarantine. The quarantine, this place called Quarantine Peace Settlement in Clarendon yesterday, and of course Burbank is under quarantine, and a lot of us have been working from home, trying to work from home, you know. Touching my face already. This is so hard. It's so hard not to do. Alright. I say it's raining like crazy. So I'm just gonna have to be so careful. How long have I been driving now? I've had my license since July 31st, 2019. So I should have August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March. 8 months. 8 months of driving along these roads. And I'm learning so much. Alright, so pre some scenery. Discriminatory, but I feel like everybody that drive in an AD wagon or a Pro Box, like them are some shutter driver or so, because you know people in Pro Boxes, AD wagons, and those ring roads, them always bad driving, always bad driver starting pack. That's what I call those guys. But maybe it's just all in my head, you know? It probably is just all in my head. Like, today I fell for some ramen noodle soup, right? But not just the regular ramen noodle soup that, you know, you buy in a packet at the supermarket. The one that you make with the chicken broth, and you have the scallion, and then you have the meat, and then the sprouts in it, and you know, those Asian, Far East Asian seasonings and all of that. But, you know, it's, you know how the supermarket is now. They're probably letting people 20-20 in at a time. And although I'm craving that soup, go sir. Yes, although I'm craving for that soup, it's not worth it to go into the supermarket. But I really, really, really like it, and I feel like I want to squeeze a little lime in it for that citrusy bit. but it's not worth it. It's not worth it to wait like for hours to go in the supermarket. I saw on someone's status, WhatsApp status, that the line to go into PriceSmart was so long. It started from in, well, of course, clearly it's gonna start from outside, but it went all the way down into the parking lot, and I'm like, boy, oh, it's rough in these streets. It's rough in these streets, man. It's really rough. But it's just the time we're living in right now. And I wish more people would take this coronavirus pandemic seriously. When I first heard about it in December, I'm like, this Wuhan virus is growing to spread across the world. And the WHO was playing. But you see, I have a proactive mom, you know. She brought up, not brought up, bought up her supplies from January, you know. So when we first heard about the cases in March, she wasn't fretting. She wasn't bomb rushing the supermarket for those supplies because she already had it a lot. Being your health is so precious. Your health is so precious, because you see, once you don't have it, your quality of life just decreases so much, and you just want to live as long as you possibly can, and you need to do the things necessary to take care of your body. You know, yeah, look at this JUTC bus just going to push out because it is a big unit. JUTC bus drivers are some of the worst drivers, you know. Not because it's a government bus. Them drive bad too. Them drive bad. No rain on Spanish Town Road. What? Is that the sun shining, shining? Who's blowing? Ooh, a gas truck. Like driving close to gas trucks or trailers, you know? I don't. Ah! I feel that every time I drop into a pothole, I just feel it. I feel it. Alright, why is there traffic here at this time of the day? Ooh, police blocked the road. Ooh, what is going on? Ooh, what is going on? I hope it's not a dead body, but it looks like it. It looks like it. Ooh, everything is at a standstill over there. I don't even want to see. Definitely cannot drive back this way. See, this taxi man just cut in front of me. You know, the world's finest drivers you can find on the road. Why are you blowing? The light just changed. Be an asshole, will you? Oh, rotted. Okay, made it. Okay, just go through. Just take it, you know? It's your road. You know, it's not like you were coming off the minor road onto the major road. Just take it, you know? Bottle. Ooh, hump. Ooh, pothole. Okay, not a pothole. Just have to be just driving over them. Alright. And then into the market district. They reopened the market today, you know, after it was closed for sanitation. Yep. The municipal corporation still hasn't fixed this sewage situation right here in front of the market, but they're sanitizing the market though. Yeah, man. Very nice. Be dodging potholes here. Driving Jamaica, you must dodge potholes. Why you point your finger at me like say me wrong? You're not easy. Future Claudia here, thanks for tuning in. I hope you saw the essence of what it is like to drive on Jamaican roads. The taxi drivers, the potholes, the other motorists on the road, and what the general road landscape in Jamaica is like. Just one tip, when the road is very narrow, just keep to the left as best as possible and do not drive fast. That is not smart. That will cause problems. So that's my road tip to you for today. So tune in for more, and thanks for watching. See you again soon. Bye.